every year. It doesn't matter what theme they choose, they're able to deliver. Remember that beautiful bridge over troubled water? They've done some great stuff.
Routine and the best skating to the routine, and it was one of the best pairs performances we've ever seen.
The winning moment was so brilliant and so exciting. Do you still have time to think about it sometimes? You know, oh, that moment, that was sort of like a lifetime experience to you. Do you still think about it at all?
No at all.
No.
I think at that moment, the Olympic game finish, life always go on, and we should challenge ourselves. When I get the medal, at that time, I just think, what's next I can do? What else I want to do? And what are my plan for figure skating in the future?
Right.
Yeah.
So let me ask this. After the short program in Beijing, you and Han Cong finished first before the long program started. And everybody was waiting for your glorious moment. But before that moment took place, did you ever think that you and Han Cong could lose, could actually finish perhaps second, maybe third? Yeah. Did it ever occur to you?
Of course, yes. It's the all year, I always think about that. It so scared me, and I just want to enjoy that time and keep going, try my best every day. I remember that time, the moment the music began, I told myself, I can do it, try my best.
When the music began, what were you thinking about?
I just want to try my best and enjoy the game. I'm also confident I can do it.
I wonder if the Beijing victory is actually a vindication of your persistence of all these years of your hard work and endeavors.
I think the key word is 迎难而上.
Facing the difficulty and get over with it.
Through my career life, I have come through many difficulties, unlist heart and operation, failure and upset. Even losing weight is so hard for me. I can't remember how many times I skated with my broken ligament. So what? I think nothing can stop me from dreaming my life. So just enjoy that moment.
When you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. Today's performance, we may not have done in the Great Spring Festival very well, but regardless, I think this is
Now you two have overcome so many difficulties.
Let's go back to talk about 4 years ago in PyeongChang Olympics. You and Han Cong, as I mentioned, finished second. Our crew actually interviewed you after your performance there, the long performance program. And you were talking to us about how you felt then. And now we're here again in person to talk about your victory in Beijing. I mean, let me show you what happened then and also tell me how you feel about, you know, this kind of comparison. Let's do that.
Thank you so much.
My colleague interviewed you 4 years ago. That's my friend, my colleague Greg.
Of course, we want to address the big issue.
There you go.
Sui Wenjing, Han Cong, thank you so much.
very big pleasure for me because I get to talk to you for a second time at these games. First, of course, we want to address the big issue, your silver medal. Congratulations on this. Now you've had a bit of time to think about it. How do you feel about your performance and getting to stand on the podium at your first Olympics?
First of all, I want to show my appreciation to my country. We skated together perhaps 11 years. Mm-hmm. Without the China give us a cultivation, we can't get any chance, so thank you.
I have good teammates and coaches. They comfort me and help me a lot. That's why I can recover so quickly.
See, that was just 4 years ago.
And I breathed that time.
No. Yeah. Time marches on. 4 years later, guess what? Sui Wenjing has finally, together with her partner, become the Winter Olympic champion. So what do you make of it?
I think every day I have hard work in my mind, in my body, and think how to get better any details, and try to make harder push my partner.
Han Cong,
yeah,
right?
Han Cong, yeah. The last year he has a surgery also on his hip. He every day feel very tired and too much pressure, I think, in his mind. Mm-hmm. So I try to make funny every day and be a...
Make him feel happy.
Yeah, making him happy and push him always. I think I always give him too much pressure. I say, you need practice more. You need to practice more, think more. I think, oh, I'm so tired. But at that time...
Did he push you as well?
Sometimes. He also protected me if I get some pain. And I want to say thank you to my partner and team. Especially I want to say thank you to my motherland. If the Olympic not in China, I can't get the so nice feeling. So I want to say thank you all.
And with all the home crowd people supporting you.
There, yeah, right? all the people, they hope we can get the medal. I think the heart power is very strong. Yeah. You are watching CGTN Sports Scene.
So people tend to ask this question though. Is Sui Wenjing going to continue her career? Especially, will she still partner with Han Cong? Because, you know, you two did very well. And would you continue to skate?
I haven't decided yet. Mm. It's a hard question.
And it's hard to decide.
Right now, I just want to have some rest to recover quickly and have some relaxed time.
So right now, Milan is not in your vision at all. You haven't thought about Milan Winter Olympics yet.
I saw something.
You did?
Yeah. But how to, in the game, how to
compete,
how to make me better, I would think, but I had to with my partner to talk with the Milan.
You're talking about Han Cong, right? So if you decide to do so, let's just say if you decide to do so, you will still pair up with Han Cong, your partner, whom you have been working with for more than 15 years now, right? It's incredible. So my next question is he your partner? Or many people would say maybe you two, a boyfriend, girlfriend.
Right now. I just want to keep my mind because I'm always a hard work person. I would like to use my time to learn something new.
So yeah, by doing so, definitely you need to develop more in your career. But people also ask, you know, since you know Han Cong is really fond of you, he takes care of you, and also you admire him in many ways, and you two cooperate so well, would that be a possibility that down the line you'll be a couple?
I don't know. In the future, who knows? Yeah, I just want
to
enjoy the
question.
Life.
Okay, yeah. There you go. But any adjustment you have to make because of the success of the Olympics. You know, now you are a big star, people are after you, and wherever you go, people tend to recognize, oh, this is Sui Wenjing, Olympic champion. Do you have to make some adjustment in order to balance your life?
I don't think it changed too much. But on the other hand, it changed somehow. I'm no longer just a little girl working hard only for her dream. I also have some responsibility. I want to be a real role model for young people in China. I think like Su Yiming, he has so much part for his life. Mm-hmm. And I learned something for him. Mm-hmm. And I just want to play with my life, try something new and challenging myself.
That is very true. Enjoy your life, really, especially your career. And what about your, say, retirement afterwards? And everybody, you know, all athletes have to retire one way or the other eventually. Would you say after your retirement you will be a coach again to following their footsteps, or you will be someone else?
Well, that's a good question. For me, I think I can be a coach, but figure skating is my favorite and my passion. I think I will try to be a figure skating choreography.
Well, choreographer is really a big challenge right there, to do beautiful choreography, you know. Yeah. That really needs a lot of knowledge, a lot of understanding of music and so forth.
Yeah, so I would love to try. I like singing, I want to make some good music, and I also love figure skating. I want to make something new. The most all famous choreographer are foreigners. I want to be a Chinese choreographer and see how far I can get.